Okay, all right. Well, this is Fabric Limited Edition. We've got 2 hours. This is Louis. I'm Terry. We've never worked together before. Louis goes to a little group called Groove School. They had a little competition and Louis come out on top. Then we're going to try and bash a tune out together in 2 hours. We did one rule we put, I said, it's 124 BPM. And then so Louis brought some samples of him. I've got some bits on the computer and some plugins and stuff that we can use. So you right. said you brought some kicks in, yeah? So what you got in here
if
then?
If you go to techno one, which is we'll
do some
on
techno,
that.
Yeah?
Yeah. Kick one shots.
You got some loops as well?
Yeah.
And some bass loops. All right, okay. Oh, there's one deep one up here.
Like that fourth one.
That one and that one I like. Yep. So we just drag that onto the screen just as one kick and just copy and paste them over.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah.
I've got the Native Instruments plug-in for the drums. We'll just get some hi-hats off there, shall we?
Yeah.
Like I say, we've got no idea where we're going. We've just been totally winging this. This is normally how I start a track anyway. Just go for it, you know? But sometimes I have an idea what I want to do, you know. Sometimes, most of the time, just what should I do today and just start off with a kick, basically. Start with a 9 and 9, then we can always change it up later. Clap, yeah?
Yeah.
Do a little shuffle in it, get a rhythm, close hi-hat.
Are you going to have 2 claps, or?
We can just stick as many claps as we want, whoever sounds good, really, you know. Yeah. You want to stick another one in there?
Yeah.
Muck around the velocities, just take one, the other one down so it sort of flutters a little bit in and out. I just normally start with the drum, kick, the hi-hats and clap to get a basic rhythm going. And then just go from there, get the bass line next. And once you sort of get some, I suppose, tones in it, then you know what to look for after that, you know, some notes in there. So you can change the sounds on here afterwards, once you've got it up going.
Quite nice and tight, isn't it? It's a bit tighter, yeah. Now, rather than a clap. So, okay, cool.
We've got the basses up there now, so then sort of go for a little bass locking bass line or something. Let's use the Native Instruments again. ES1, that's it. Always put mono, bass in mono. Otherwise, it just rattles around the room too much and just doesn't sound so cool. Oh, we've got to put this on the keyboard. There we go. Deep bass line, I think that's probably the best. That. Just muck around with the cut off and the resonance just to get the right sort of tone on it and that, you know.
Yeah.
Let's have a look in there, see what's going on. I didn't even realise I was recording that when I was tapping away then, but it sort of sounds all right.
Yeah.
Cheeky little mistake, really.
I usually start with a kick and then the clap and then I just go from there and then I move to the bass line and then I kind of get a feel of what I want the track to be from there.
Head percussion or whatever.
Yeah.
Same pretty much what I do as well. Just feel the vibe of it really, isn't it? Copy the bass line over and see if we can get some chords going off that and maybe just add some more drums after that and then sort of get started a bit more. Just get the basic elements in there.
Yeah.
I use this every now and again, this loop cloud, and get some nice little bits of percussion on there, like tribally bits, and you can pretty much choose what you want. It's just really accessible, you know. We just need a Wi-Fi connection, basically.
Is it for free?
No, you have to pay. It's like £6 a month or something. You get so many sample downloads every month. I think it's 500 or something, which is pretty cool.
I've only started using samples recently. I get my samples from a website called Ghost Hack.
Some of them you can tell if they're going to be a bit cheesier and you can tell if they're going to be a bit no point, you know. It's just so many, you just have to, you know, it's a bit time consuming, but it's probably the easiest way to get a groove going, isn't it? You know, you get something different, you know, rather than something you wouldn't play, you know. So it's quite cool.
I like that.
Yeah,
triangle.
Like yeah.
You can just drag them in.
Just take it out of here. Right. And just drag them into a triangle. I think we both like that one, didn't we? Nice when you catch the end of one of these and just put in two little beeps in. But let's try some of them other bits of rhythms that we did collect. If you're using samples, it's fine stuff you wouldn't normally write yourself. I think house music built on there is really, you change the sound over to a different sound and because something comes out that and you think, oh wow, that sounds, that's amazing, you know.
If it works, it works.
If it works, it doesn't. It's just, I mean, I'm not a musician, you know what I mean? I'm just winging it basically, but it sounds good, you know. Yeah. House music has progressed a lot on just accidents, you know.
Yeah.
Definitely all sorts of music, you know. It's a different tempo, though. It's not in the right tempo. So if you go into it here and then put on the flex here, which is this little button there, have you used it? Use that. You can flex it. So it sort of opens it to the right and quantize it. And it makes it pretty much to the right. So that changes it.
Yeah.
So at this point, we should save it, really, in case you lose it. I've done that so many times. That's a good tip, that, because I've lost so many, not so much on the Mac, but I mean, if you're using a PC and whatever, it's crashing.
The battery dies.
Well, the battery dies,
That's happened to me.
Is it?
Yeah.
So gutted, isn't it? When you've nearly done the track and then...
You try and rush to turn it back on.
Sort of interesting. Yeah, I've never been taught how to use Logic, just sitting in studios for years and picking up things and that, you know, and just learning myself. It's logical, it's all quite self-explanatory, isn't it?
It almost sounds like another sound, you know, sometimes when you put these two reverbs, Tony's reverbs on them.
Just got a little arrangement going.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Start with the kick and that. I mean, with this, with the drum, the machine, the Native Instrument one, you can just take your pattern, as you click on here, turns it into a wave, basically.
Okay.
So you want to copy, like, just copy some stuff across, really, innit, and get it on the move. It will struggle a bit, the speakers, isn't it? We need some bass taken out of things, and it's all a bit rumbly.
Do you usually have an order where things go?
Not really, no. It just depends where it fits, really. At the beginning, normally the more subtle things. Then I get the basic sort of template of the track and then start mucking around with the sounds a little bit more, trying to get them sounding a bit sweet. That's, again, it's trial and error, you know, just sort of go through some effects and that, you know. And I do anyway, I mean, just try them out. You know? Like we are now, we sort of hit a bit of a block, you know, and then you just find one more sound or one more bit of inspiration, you're just off again, you know what I mean? And this is the point where I'd probably take a bit of a break, go and have a couple of pints down the pub, a bit of sit in the corner, get my thoughts together, you know what I mean? Because there's a lot of information to take in.
Yeah.
And
it's easy to give up, but...
Yeah, no, I never would give up on a track, but you come back and just find the right sound and find the right element for it, and then you're off again, you know, on the roll. Coming back to it, having a little fiddle around, just getting some different elements in, like I say, and we're off again, you know. Some tunes, they just come together straight away. You just nail it. Everything I put in it seems to work, you know. Yeah. And then other times you sort of hit a bit of a wall and you come back to it later and you're off again, you know. It's just, there's nothing wrong with this at the moment. It sounds all right, but there's just certain elements that are just not quite laying in there, you know. But then if you had a couple of days to do a tracking, then you'd get that right, you know. Something's twice in it, you know, we've done that.